Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, our refuge, our delight, our beginning, and our end.
Amen.
Let us come in truth before the one who loves us and has freed us from our sin. pray. O God, you show forth your mighty power, and chiefly by reaching known to us in mercy. Grant us the fullness of your grace, strengthen our trust in your promises, and bring all the world to share with the treasures among your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior. and ask you a question to ponder, and then if you feel so moved, you can share your response to that question. A little further on, after we read it again, I'll give you the question ahead of time so that you can think about the text and the question together. The Holy Gospel according to Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. As Jesus taught, he said, "Beware of the scribes, who like to walk around in long robes, and to be greeted with respect in marketplaces, and to have the best seats in the synagogues and places of honor at banquets. They devour widows' houses, and for the sake of appearances say long prayers. They will receive greater commendation." Jesus sat down opposite the treasurer and watched the crowd putting money into the treasury. Many rich people put in large sums. A poor widow came and put in two small copper coins, which are worth a penny. Then he called his disciples and said to them, "Truly I tell you, this poor widow has put in more than all those who have contributed in the treasury. For all of them have contributed out of their abundance, but she out of her poverty has put in everything she had, all that she had to live on." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
What is a word, phrase, or image that catches your attention in our Gospel reading? Long robes. We hear it again. As Jesus taught, he said, "Beware the scribes, who like to walk around in long robes, and to be greeted with respect in marketplaces, and to have the best seats in the synagogues and places of honor and payments. They devour widows' houses, and for the sake of appearances say long prayers. They will receive a greater condemnation." Jesus sat down opposite the treasury and watched the crowd putting money into the treasury. And the rich people put in large sums. A poor widow came and put in two small copper coins, which are worth a penny. Then he called his disciples and said to them, "Truly I tell you, this poor widow has put in more than all those who contributed to the treasury. For all of them have contributed out of their abundance, but she out of her poverty has put in everything she had, all that she had to live on." What is a memory that this passage brings up? the story again. This time, listen for a challenge for you or for our world. As Jesus taught, he said, "Beware of scribes who like to walk around in long robes and to be greeted with respect in marketplaces, and to have the best seats in the synagogues and places of honor at banquets. They devour widows' houses, and for the sake of appearances say long prayers. They will receive the greater condemnation." Jesus sat down opposite the treasury and watched the crowd putting money into the treasury. Many rich people put in large sums. A poor widow came and put in two small copper coins, which are worth a penny. And he called his disciples and said to them, "Truly I tell you, this poor widow has put in more than all those who contributed to the treasury. For all of them have contributed out of their abundance. But she, out of her poverty, has put in everything she had, all she had to live on." What that you heard, did you hear as a challenge for you or our world? We hear our gospel one last time, and this time we listen for a gift or a promise for you or our world. A gift or a promise for you or our world. As Jesus taught, he said, "Beware the scribes who like to walk around in long robes, and to be greeted with respect in the marketplaces, and to have the best seats in the synagogues, and places of honor at banquets. They devour widows' houses, and for the sake of appearances say long prayers. They will receive the greater condemnation." He sat down opposite the treasury and watched the crowd putting money into the treasury. Many rich people put in large sums. A poor widow came and put in two small copper coins, which are worth a penny. Then he called his disciples and said to them, "Truly I tell you, this poor widow has put in more than all those who have contributed to the treasury. For all of them have contributed out of their own.
sing together.
Thank you.
and inside Presbyterian Church, all are welcome to come and hear what Charming is up to. Sandwich and Scripture will meet in the narthex on Wednesday at 11:30. That's a midweek Bible study. We'll get together and listen to the readings for the next Sunday. Quilters are gathered on Thursday at 9:30. It's really a flexible time, isn't it? I mean, people show up when they show up. But they get together, make some quilts, have some coffee, and drink together. All are welcome for that. And the Bridges to Christ also give out a big thank you to all who donated for the Chunk Thanksgiving dinners. They collected about $500, which is amazing and awesome. Are there any other announcements for you all? You received the offering. Lord Jesus, our portion and our cup, you offer yourself in the love of the Lord, and in his sacrament, nourish us for your life. Fill us with your abundance, that we may feed the hungry and welcome the stranger. Trust in you, your name. Amen. gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take it, eat. This is my body, given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, the great of Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, behold, God is making everything new. Take your place in the creation.
Thank you.
spread before us a feast of rich food and drink, the body and blood of your Son. Now send us out to labor with you in service to the world you have made and among the people you have made your home. In Jesus Christ.